right, guys. So, David's picking up the next giveaway truck that we are going to show you the build from the start to the end. And here he is right now.
Dang. Dude, that thing is clean, bro.
Thing's big.
It's gonna even fit.
Did you bring us a toy?
Got a big old toy.
Dude. Oh, man. Dude, that's a sexy truck right there.
I think our shop is too small for this truck. We need an upgrade.
I
think we can work with this one.
I think we can make some magic happen.
Woo! Now we just need to brainstorm on what we're gonna do with it.
So we're gonna take you guys on the whole process of this build from the start to the end. We're gonna build it here in the next few weeks and give it away. So we're gonna basically change the look. How it looks right now is gonna look a whole lot different.
We almost need to sit down for this one and see what we can do with it.
Nick, what do you think, bro?
I like it.
Like the truck?
F450?
A 450,
dude. A 450.
So I like how it's mostly stock. That means that we have a blank canvas to work with right now.
Uh-huh.
We have a lot of room for potential here.
So what, any level lift?
Any level lift?
42-inch tires?
So
30s?
That any level lift is like the alpha lift. The lift we had in alpha where you just click a button, it goes up, down.
13 inches in height.
13 inches up.
Oh, man. I don't know. That might be a little bit too much for this truck.
That sounds a little crazy.
Maybe like a 6 or 8 inch lift.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm thinking like keeping this truck like, we got to keep it practical, so realistic. You know, I mean, it's a big truck. It's going to be a workhorse. It needs to be practical.
Does that have M steps?
It does.
It's got M steps ready.
Sure does. That's huge. So that means we can put a lift on it.
I'm sure people can get in it without a problem. So, this is going to be a fun one, dude.
Yeah.
Transforming this thing into a giveaway truck is going to be fun. This would be fun.
Are you guys ready for this? Are you guys ready? I think we gotta sit down and brainstorm.
We need to wow our customers with our next giveaway.
Yes.
Wow. Okay.
They're not ready.
That is the plan. So
we set the bar high with all the other builds.
So. Yeah. I mean, what was Guardian was what 37s?
37s. I mean, I mean, that was the only cool giveaway, but that whole
76.
Yeah. Like 7s.
Yeah.
On 20.
That was 26.
26.
I think 26s would be too much on this one.
Just because the F450, just to give more rubber.
Do we want to stick with the 37 though?
37, yes, 37s. I like
37s. Healthy.
So I mean, I don't want to do the thin profile. I want to have some meat in those tires.
We gotta stop talking with this guy then.
They don't like that. I run 24s on 33s.
Substituting big time boy here.
These are 24s.
See, I do like that.
But hear me out.
More wheels.
You want alpha?
A little
super
bit.
Singles.
Super singles.
Yeah. Super singles up front.
6-inch lift. Super singles. 24-inch tires. 24-inch rims. 37-inch tires.
You're gonna need a 6-inch.
So the 6-inch lift will clear the super single.
The 6-inch lift, because we're only doing, I think we should only do 12 points.
14, yeah, 14,
I've seen 14s on the big.
Definitely not.
Yeah.
The 12 likes, only for 12s on 37s.
Yeah, because they're doing
a little offset there. And
yeah, it'll give that, I mean, you have this huge fender going up front, factory, 450.
Some forged, nice,
polished
wheels. We're going to have to find somebody, because I mean, the lead times on that is like 4 weeks right now.
And we want to launch in the January.
Yeah.
And today's December 28th.
Yeah. So we'll make some calls.
So we're a month away from launching, and that takes 4 weeks to the wheels.
You guys will have the wheels by the time you win it.
I owe you some wheels.
Yeah.
Color of the truck.
It's gray.
So
we can. All right. Well, let's ask this. We want to keep the chrome. I guess that depends if we keep what color we go with, right?
Yeah, what color?
Because we could always wrap this thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Make something.
So not just a black.
Pop, you know.
Dude, you know,
color of wrap that you had on your truck?
Oh, dude, that was good.
Matte metallic too. Blue.
Does it have the flake like metallic in the sun?
Dude, I love that color. Like every time I drove it, I love that color. It popped.
I've never seen that.
It was one of a kind.
Yeah. No, I had never seen that color before I saw it on your truck.
I really liked that.
I don't think there's an F-450 out there with that kind of color too. So this would be really unique.
I don't know if there's a blue F-450s out there.
No.
Let alone that
color. That would be sick.
I like
that. Would be sick.
So no one's right.
If we do wrap it matte metallic blue, we can use the color of the truck as our powder coat color.
So an accent
color.
So basically, we have all the coils.
I have that wrap. So let me grab the wrap and hold it off next to it.
Yeah, let's see.
Let's see how that looks.
All right, so we're still brainstorming here, but
check this out. Let's see how this looks.
Check that out.
Chrome.
So that's a satin blue, satin metallic blue.
We leave the chrome as the accent.
Looks really good.
What if all the plastics we do in the body color, along with all the powder coat? Because think, eventually that wrap's gonna get taken off.
Right.
And then it'll all match.
And then if we have the headlights color match the truck with the blue after. It's gonna tie it in. We take the plastic part
so
and color match that
to the truck. So this would
these be these are this color. Then this will line up like that.
Right.
I think that'll look.
And so you're thinking leaving like this line here?
No. Okay. We're just saying because these headlights are still chrome. If these headlights are this color, let's just pretend the headlight ends here so we can see them next to each other.
These two colors flow really well though.
And then we have also chrome here, which we can leave sections out to. Like we got the tow hooks, we can leave like little
out. Paint this gray, all the plastics.
Mm-hmm.
Grill, I don't know yet whether we color match it to the truck or black it out.
The cool part about this whole thing that is if the person that wins it decides to take the wrap off,
it'll be color matched.
So
it's just
a clean look already. So it's going to be a unique by itself with that wrap, and then. If you don't want that unique look, you just have a color match truck, and that's sweet.
So we'll take the headlights apart, get them color matched, get a whole bunch of things here color matched.
That was the chrome handle on.
Chrome, yeah, that looks.
Yeah, I'll leave the chrome.
The chrome does look good with that.
I like that.
So the springs, the suspension can be color matched to the truck.
It'll all be lit up.
We're thinking a 6-inch lift.
With, I think, polished faceplates to tie some of the polished in from the wheels into the lift. Some of the little face plates on the top of the coil pad.
Yes.
Front radius arms.
And then we have
the chrome matching throughout.
Yep. That way you kind of blend the chrome. Just we'll decide about the caps and this chrome, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Dude, yeah, that looks sweet. That would look sweet.
Starlight headliner.
Oh, it needs a starlight.
With the inner force like usual.
Yeah. Dude, we've done two trucks so far with Starlight, right?
Two, yeah.
And it looks, dude, I mean, it's hard to look at a truck without it now.
Right?
It's like, why is it not lit up?
I think we need next level mats again for these ones. Those mats were killer.
Those mats were killer.
We did a super good job on them.
We can do a grit black with a gray with this color on the mat.
Yep.
Because on the Cobra, we did
a
black
mat with a white inlay. This one would be black wrap or black mat with a gray inlay.
Uh-huh. That'd be sick.
Switchbacks, throw some switchbacks in here.
White cab light. I think we're gonna have to debadge it with the wrap.
Debadge. So we need to get some tires, lift,
wheels.
Wheels. Take everything off, color match it. Starlight headliner.
Rock lights.
Rock lights, yes. Light it up.
I think what would be fitting with this truck is a huge Gen Y hitch on the back. Just a big Gen Y drop.
I need a hitch. Needs it.
Gen Y.
Good. We'll have Nick hitting his shin every time.
Right? Workman's comp.
Yeah.
This is bullshit.
Oh, you got to bring up a good point.
It was my idea, but I'm going to take advantage of it.
Okay. So that's kind of a plan. Now we can just take it apart and
put back together.
Get to work because, boys, January, end of January, ain't going to be any further tomorrow.
So we've only got a few short weeks to get this build going, wrap it up, and give it away. So
we got a lot of phone calls to make.
A lot of stuff to do. I'm worried about the wheels. Actually, I'm worried about everything.
Yeah. You guys are gonna get a lot of IOU.
Yeah.
No, we've gotten them all done before.
Yeah, we'll get it done.
All righty, so that's a plan.
Let's go make some calls, boys.
Let's do it.
It takes one shot to just pull it in.
Don't hit it.
hit anything, Nick.
We got a driver that I'm not sure if we can trust, but he's gonna do it.
I didn't hit the wire like you did.
Okay. Back of the truck with Nick over here. We're about to go shoot some rollers on that sick truck while it's stopped. We don't have much time, but it's gonna be taken apart here tonight. So we're gonna get some rollers on the stock while we can. Beautiful truck, okay? 6.7 liter power stroke engine. This thing is ready to go to work. So we're gonna take the headlights off. They're gonna be color matched, taking the grill off. Color matching all of this. This new emblem's gonna be a light up emblem, kind of like on Covert. So that'll be nice. Connor's doing over here.
All right, it's no longer a 4x4.
No longer a 4x4? I've got a thin thing.
Ooh, that's exactly.
Nope,
that is not what I needed. This one is kidding.
Guys, I've been slowly tearing apart this grill. All of these pieces separated out of here. Now just to get all of these little tiny clips. So far, so good.
Having fun here yet? Taking apart this grill? Clip by clip, huh? And off it goes. All right, next thing is take this black off. This is gonna be color matched to the truck. Color matched. This will be color matched to the truck. So let's take this off and then we'll move on to taking the rest of this stuff off and then down to the rear bumper and the hitch. Ready. Time to take the plaque off. Gotta disconnect it from here. It's a pain. But we'll get it. So yeah, you gotta pretty much break off all the pins on the bottom and then put new pins after. Got it. And this sounds done. So yeah, these bottom clips break off, but then you just get new clips, throw them in there, put it back on there. It'll be better than new and a lot prettier. So this one will go off the paint.
Alrighty guys, it is the next day here. Truck is pretty much all torn apart. Obviously not suspension or anything, but all the plastics that need to go to paint. Still gotta drop the hitch for powder, but all the marker lights are out, all the plastics are off the back bumper, whole front end is torn apart. They have a little teaser of the wrap. Mirrors are all taken apart. Bumper, all the plastics are off. This is all the grill, side emblems, mirror caps, glass for the mirrors. Gotta debadge that.
We left the cab lights on just so water doesn't go in the cab if we do have to drive it to wrap without before the new cab lights get here, but overall, it is torn apart.
Good morning, another beautiful day here at Interforce. So last night, we actually got done tearing apart the truck, and now we're gonna take it to get a color match. Well, I think that is it, and let's head on over, drop these off, and then start ordering more parts, because this build is gonna be something, I'll tell you that right now. I think everyone's here pretty excited on how this next truck is gonna come out, so let's jump in and go deliver the stuff.
Duramax, who's a fan of Duramax is here.
380,000 on this LBZ, so still runs. That's all good. I like that. Got a little bit of rubbish, but
go take our parts.
Tail lights are gonna get color matched and tinted.
It's gonna be good.
All right, well, the day continues. The color match parts are at the paint shop, so they're gonna get painted in the next few days. I'm on my way now to get a color match for the truck, for the suspension. So we're gonna try to get something as close as we can to the actual truck color. If we wanted to order exact color, we would have to wait 4 weeks. And we don't have 4 weeks, we've got like 2 weeks to be ready to take pictures. So I'm gonna go and pick the best color that we can get, because powder is gonna get powder coated next week, probably like Wednesday, Thursday. And then we'll be ready to start putting the truck together. So I'm really excited for that. So hopefully we can find the right color, go from there, and make this build come together. So a lot of driving today, a lot of driving. Got like 3 hours of driving today. Nice. And still getting stuff, still getting shit done.
Woo!
Let's go, buddy. Colorado, look at this. Can you believe this? It is December 29th, and it is clear as day outside in Denver, Colorado. Huh? Seriously, what is going on here? I guess the mountains right now are getting a lot of snow, but we're like an hour away from the mountains, and we're not getting anything. Kind of sucks. Oh, that sun though. Oh. All right, that's much better. Let's hit the road, ladies and gentlemen. Got a long way to go, a lot of things to do. Like this hoodie right here, it says, get shit done. Gotta get shit done every single day, you know? That's how you do it. Grab yourself a hoodie and get some shit done, boys and girls.